Ba-ba-da-ba. La-da-da. Hey, how's it going? Dan Schinder here on Drum Talk TV. I'm going to come around in the playpen in a moment. We have some fun lined up to celebrate 50 freaking years of Led Zeppelin IV, the untitled album. Yes, indeed. Starting a couple minutes early, but just to buy some time, actually. It doesn't make sense. So, yeah, hey, thanks for joining me. I appreciate it. Moving into the holiday season. Hope everyone's well. Couple things I want to mention. Today, as this is being broadcast live, we are right in the middle of our feature videos. A lot of videos today from fans who submitted, and we've included in the Drumming Away Diabetes campaign that we're doing online. And I want to make sure that everybody knows that when we say drumming away diabetes, we don't mean that that means it going away. That's the name of the campaign to raise money for the American Diabetes Association. That's the name of the campaign. Get it? Drumming away diabetes. I have diabetes. I was diagnosed when I was already a senior, a couple and a half years ago. Hey, Rich Moose. And let me know where you folks are watching from. I'm in Globe, Arizona, small rural town up in the mountains. Why is this so close? About 100 miles east of Phoenix. Let's get this situated. There we go. I think the cat's been in here. it came as a shock to me because I kind of don't look like a stereotypical diabetic, if you know what I mean. I'm not overweight and all that. In fact, I lost a lot of weight. So yikes. Yeah, that was a trip. But anyhow, I'm feeling much better. I'm doing much better. If you have diabetes, if you know someone with diabetes, if you've been affected by diabetes in any way, if you know anyone that's heard the word diabetes, please share this with them. In the post, there are links where people can contribute to the campaign on the official Drum Talk TV page of the American Diabetes Association page. I'm going to read some comments in just a moment. Chime in, please. So my A1C when I got diagnosed was 12.9, which came as a shock because I didn't grow up eating candy and punch and all that stuff. But my doctor says that I probably gave myself diabetes from years of being a juiceaholic and fruitaholic. Sounds healthy, right? But some bodies just, we change, and not all healthy things are healthy for everybody. So I'm fighting the fight and inviting you to help us all fight it together, raise money for research and for supplies for those less fortunate who can't afford it. I have a new business partner and a whole other venture, and I had no idea that her husband, who's 74, is bedridden from diabetes, from the neuropathy being so bad. And he's type 2. He's not even type 1. So anyhow, please help. But let's have some fun with celebrating 50 years of Led Zeppelin's untitled album, often referred to as Led Zeppelin IV or Zo-So, or named after the big flash in the pan hit from the album Stairway to Heaven. Yeah. So I found, and I'll get to comments. Please keep chiming in. Thank you. My favorite version of stuff to play to from Led Zeppelin is if I'm going to play a live bootleg, and I'll tell you why I choose bootlegs and why you should too, is from The Song Remains, the same tour. Movie came out in 76. The tour is in 73. So I found a great recording. I've never played to it. I haven't even listened to the whole thing. I listened to like little pieces of a couple songs to see how the sound quality is. So dangerous. Why do I do this? Why do I do this? But that's part of the adventure. So I'll tell you what songs I'm going to play. I'm going to play Rock and Roll, Black Dog, Misty Mountain Hop, and Stairway to Heaven. But I'm not going to play the guitar long intro. We'll chit-chat during that part. And hopefully, these versions are really close to what I'm used to playing to The Song Remains the Same movie soundtrack. But one thing about them is they never, especially John Bonham, never wanted to play the same thing the same way twice. So this is a little dangerous, but I'm going to do my thing. It's all for fun. It's all for fun. And you can see I'm at my big kit. I did not have time to disassemble it and turn it into my bonzo kit. I got my timpanis here. So I'm only going to use what John used. I'm just going to use kick, snare, one tom, floor toms, these two cymbals, and the timpani drums. I'm not using small toms, no splash or bell, no stacker, no china. We're just going to use what he used. No double pedal. Do not, Jason Bonham, do not use a double pedal when you play Led Zeppelin, because he didn't. Anyways, so let's see who's on board, what's happening, what's going on, what are you doing, what hand are you doing it with, and what are you going to do with it when you're done doing it to it. So Rich Moses says, Dred Zeppelin, actually knew those guys years and years ago. I grew up in California. Coco, Florida, Pete Martin, thank you. Joshua, VP, hey, Dan. Belgium here. You're a type 2, right? Yes, I am, and I see you're type 1. Hang in there. How long have you had it? How are you doing with it? Bob Bailey, hope you're well. Glad to see you. You too, Bob. Thanks for chiming in. I feel really well. Getting ready to go on vacation. Leaving tomorrow for 10 days. Really excited about that. Going to roll around with grandsons and see my daughter, her husband. Steven Schinder's going with us, my son. And John, hope I'm pronouncing your name right. John J. Ruan Jr. from Smyrna, Delaware. Nice. Chris Taylor, Fairhaven, Massachusetts. Brian Cahoon, how you doing, Brian? Brian, I always forget where you are. I'm so embarrassed by that because you're on like all the time and we connect elsewhere in the Facebook-osphere. Yeah, Pete Martin, this is a great version of Stairway to Heaven too. Even though I haven't heard the whole thing, it's from that same tour and I know what that's like. God, I hope the improv part's about the same. Forgot to say Chicago, Bob. Thank you. Rod Billinghurst in Grit City, Washington. Grew up with Rod. We used to build and race cars illegally. Built them legally, raced them illegally. I'm pretty sure the statute of limitations has run out on that, Rod, so don't worry. plus, I got my Drum Talk TV card. Just flashed that, and it's instant out of trouble. No, it's instant in trouble is what that is. Mike Holden from Nova Scotia, beautiful part of the world, and especially North America. Thank you. Jorge Bravo in Uruguay. Nice. Thank you. Cheers from Tarana. Let's hear your Purdy Shuffle. Well, it's not on the album we're celebrating, but I'll tell you what, just to get warmed up, we'll do that. Let me see if I've got my bonzo tuning down. Thanks for bringing that up. There you go. That's all you get. So let's go ahead and, like Brian Cahoon says, let it rip. There's Vicky McWaters, who, by the way, hates... Vicky McWaters is the director of directing development of the American Diabetes Association of the Arizona and New Mexico pod. And I happen to be on that board of directors. I'm so honored, so excited. And she does... love Stairway to Heaven. Great. And thank you, Sammy. Thank you. So go ahead and comment while I'm playing. I'll look at it after. Let's let it rip. Hopefully this version I can hang. Hopefully I can hear well. Getting hearing aids within a year. I don't wear hearing protection. Well, I do sometimes, but I'm not right now. So why do I play to bootlegs? Because if you do play-alongs with official tracks, they'll get muted or pulled down, deleted. Your channel can get shut down. I've worked way too hard to build a following of over 1 million followers on Facebook for Drum Talk TV without boosting a post or paying for an ad. So I'm not going to risk that. So instead, I play to bootlegs where the sound's a little and the versions are all different and I'm not used to them. Found a new one. Let's walk that tightrope together. Here we go. You'll know this first song if you know the movie especially. So here we go. Nervous. I'll let them sing. version. But there you go, my little sloppy bucket of fish ending there that he does. How's this sound? Is the audio okay? I could actually hear that pretty well, which was a real treat. I'm going to switch back to your screen, take a quick sip of tea. And I did see somebody say something in regards to diabetes, that, yeah, diet is the key. I'm out of breath. And it's sometimes hard to stick to that. I'm pretty strict, but I'm not going to say what I had for lunch. I'm pretty strict, but it's hard. It's difficult. That's the biggest challenge. Quick sip of tea. Let me know how you doing. And thanks, Stephen, for the note. So Joshua says, hey, Dan, all good. Thanks to see you're doing well. Yes, I was diagnosed in 2019. After 3 months of being sick, I went to an arsenal of doctors, no result, ended up in the ER with almost, 1,000 sugar, glucose, I'm sure, I hope you mean, coma. 3 years later, HbA1c equals 5.3. Wow, good for you. Have a new puppy. I just got a puppy. Have a new puppy, and life is different. Following the diet and moving and music equals gold. Very nice. And for the people that don't know, if you have to pee more urgent than normal, if you are abnormally thirsty, and if you have fruity breath, go to a doc. Great advice. And regular checkup if you have diabetes in the family, and keep an eye on it. And of course, let nothing stop you. Drums all the way. What a great note, Joshua. Thank you. So my parents didn't have it, or my grandparents. That made it even more of a shock. Oh, that's great, Pepsi. I'm just kidding. It's iced tea without the ice. What a story. Good for you. No royalties for bootlegs. Since I've Been Loving You is a great song, but not from the album that we're celebrating. Yep, Black Dog's up next. Salta City, North Virginia. Pablo Amedo Jimenez, hola, ¿cómo estás? ¿Qué estás haciendo, amigo? From Switzerland. Oh, from Ecuador, living in Switzerland. Boris, good on you. Thank you for joining us. That's right, Bridget, North Carolina. Brian Cahoon. All right. Mike Holden also says, same intro as Little Richard. Yeah, absolutely. You know, speaking of that, let's talk real quickly how the drums are different. And then I'm going to look at more comments. So the way the drums are different on what I just played, this tour version, is that it's got a more stomping swing to it. The beat goes on. Whereas on the album, it's more... it's just kind of like chopping through, and I love the groove that he puts in it in the live version. So I saw something else. Sarah Blakeway, greetings from Australia. How are things in Oz? I haven't been there in about 10, 11 years. Lived there for a while. Thank you, Andrew Griffith. Okay, so let's move on. Walter White, drummer. You goddamn right. Say my name. Say my name. Marvin. Good catch, good catch. All right, next we have Black Dog. And on this tour, they did two different intros. They did either Out on the Tiles, or they did the beginning of Bring It On Home. And I'm pretty sure this is the Bring It On Home version, which I just love. And then we're going to do Misty Mountain Hop, then Stairway to Heaven. All right, here we go. Hopefully I can. Thanks for joining me. Here we go. Can't see. Hopefully that's it.
Wait.
Accidentally hit the pang. I know. After I made a big deal about that, right? Whew. Wow. This is a fun workout. Very good for diabetes. If you didn't hear the spiel, be sure to check out the deal. Look at the notes. And if I'll look at comments in a moment. Thank you. Get some more tea. If you buy a Drum Talk TV shirt, and we got 36 designs. If you buy a Drum Talk TV shirt, I'm donating all the proceeds to the American Diabetes Association. Buy a shirt anytime this year. Treat yourself, treat someone else, buy it, give it away, fly it as a flag, whatever you want to do. Just buy it, and I'm going to donate the money to the American Diabetes Association. And there's other ways you can contribute, and the links are in the post. So stay with me for now. We got two more songs to go. One of them I haven't played in like a really long time. Misty Mountain Hop, the Tolkien song. We'll get to that in a sec. I should have brought more tea, but I think I have some water in the fridge. All right, let's see what's happening. What's going on? Great job hitting bell of cymbals. Thank you. I love that part of the song. Thanks so much, Pete. Mike Holden says, do you think Bonzo's sound would have been different had he used the traditional grip? Yeah, I do, even though there's some really heavy hitters that play trad grip, like Steve Smith, Dean Castronovo, Todd Zuckerman, of course. So yeah, absolutely. Hey, Ram. How's it going, Ram? Thank you so much. Oh yeah, Four Sticks. I got to see if I could find a live version of that. That's right, Four Sticks is on this album. But I don't, so I have to play to a bootleg so that it doesn't get snagged. I will see if it's in this concert or not that I'm playing to right now. If not, we'll look for it. Thank you for the reminder. Thank you so much, Pablo. Great sound. Can hear everything clearly, David. I'll tell David. I'm Dan. That's okay. I've been called worse just today here at home by the cat. Okay, let's keep it moving. Here we go. Thanks, Chris. All right. So next, I wonder if Four Sticks is on this. That is fun to play. And those sticks always want to get away from me. I'll tell you what, if I can't find it, I'll play the beat. I'll play it a cappella, if that makes sense, which is drums. So is it on here? I don't know if they ever played that live, to tell you the truth. Misty Mountain Hop, this is dangerous because I've never played to this version. So we'll see how that goes. And I haven't played it in a long time, period. It's got, so can you hear me okay, hopefully? On Black Dog, the live version during the ba-da-da-dum, ba-da-ba, is where his foot's getting away. That going on. A lot of fun stuff. Okay, here we go. Yeah, it's lined up. As long as I don't move the cursor and play Battle of Evermore instead. it goes into Since I've Been Loving You right there. Some of that was hard to hear, as you could tell. A little mushy there. So now for the grand finale, because that's all the time I have. We're only playing songs from this album, but I will look for Four Sticks after this. Let's see what this version of Stairway to Heaven's like. I won't play the guitar part, obviously, but I will skip through this a bit, if you don't mind. I'll look at comments in a moment. That one was hard to hear. I'm sure that totally sucked. Okay, let's see here. Comments. All right, I'm going to pause that so I can read and pay attention. Thank you, Kathy. I've had this drum kit like forever. Brian, thanks for joining us. Mark Doran, how have you been? Love you too. I'll catch up later this year. Looking forward to hearing Led Zeppelin. Awesome. Thank you. I hope you and your mom are well. Hope everybody's well. Everybody on board. Let me scroll up, see what else is going on. Pete Martin says, sorry, Dan. New here and don't have my readers on. Okay, as his can't get the same power sound using traditional. I can't either. I don't know how those guys keep their sticks in their hands. Hey, Jeff Harris, how are you? Kasaba Gallery, thank you for joining us. Jordan Mathis, Followage, thank you. DJ Jackie Bennett, what's going on? Greensville, South Carolina, cool. Let's carry on with this version of Stairway to Heaven. Then I'll see if I can find four sticks. If not, I'll just demonstrate the beat with four sticks. We'll be right back. Yeah. Bootlegs sometimes can get a little mushy there. And I don't know if you noticed, but all four of those songs, like, way slower than normal, even from other clips, takes from the same tour. So let's see. I'll check comments in a moment. Let's see. So I don't know if they ever played Four Sticks live. Let me check. Who knows how that sounds? And if not, I'll just play part of it and demonstrate the beat. So I'll check comments, like I said. Please support the campaign we're doing today. Four Sticks, Led Zeppelin Live. Here we go. Let's see. Four Sticks. Okay, Copenhagen. Let's see how that sounds. Oh, that's right. They did it with the Page Plant thing with the orchestra. Remember that? Who remembers that? Pete says, Daniel, great group player, took lock it down with Misty, but yeah, it was very hard to hear that. Thank you so much. Oh, thank you. Thank you for that. I appreciate that. Hello from Cadiz, Spain. Moises Ibanez Garcia, how are you? I love your guitar brand, by the way. I have an 8-string mandolin like Jimmy's from Ibanez. Technique, power, and groove. Thank you so much, everybody. I really, really appreciate it. Yeah, weird timing, and also just the sound isn't that good on some bootlegs. But and Pablo, thank you as well. Let's see what's left. Let's see what this Misty Mountain Hop business sounds like. I mean, Four Sticks. What band are we doing again? Let me just hear some of this. Give me a sec here. See if I can hear this well enough. No way. Okay, that won't cut it. Let me see a different version. That's funny. Let's see. We're not giving up yet. Four Sticks remaster. Four Sticks. I'm looking for the actual live version. Four Sticks Live. Here's another one. Let's see if it's a different show. This is also Denmark. It might be exactly the same. I think it is. That's the same shit version. Sorry, oops. Was that out loud? And I can't play an official one. Here's also Copenhagen. Oh, that's the whole show. Hold on, I'm not giving up yet. I'll do one song outside of this album as a little encore thingy. But in the meantime, while you all make suggestions, and maybe a short one, hint, hint. So, Four Sticks. Do I even have Four Sticks the same? I don't. So the song goes dun, 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 dun. Two of them are broken, these two. I don't know if you heard me talking. Two of them are broken. The ones in my left hand are kind of wonky. So there's the beat to Four Sticks. Let's see what suggestions we have for one last. And thanks again, everybody, for joining me. No suggestions, so maybe I'll just go. Please support the Drumming Away Diabetes Campaign live online right now. And buy a Drum Talk TV shirt. I'll donate all the proceeds. The link is in the post. Go to the American Diabetes official website and the Drumming Away Diabetes Drum Talk TV page where you can donate. You can share the link to others. It's all in the post. Please support, support, support. This is a horrible disease. I know I have it, and it sucks. At least I'm not peeing in the bed anymore. I'm not. I'm done with that, I think. That's good, right? And if you have a story to tell and you play drums, send in videos. Steven, maybe you could drop in the link to submit videos I don't think I have that in there. And you don't have to have diabetes to submit videos. But if you do, tell your story, play some drums, play a solo, do a warm-up, do your favorite Austin Audio, your favorite practice gig, or play to music, but play either with a band or to bootlegs, not official tracks. We can't post those, okay? So let's see. Oh, well, thank you, Pablo. That's hard to live up to, but thank you, and thank you so much for joining us. Pablo, I'm just curious how long you've been following Drum Talk TV, and everyone's welcome to chime in on that. I'm curious, because I see some names I haven't seen in a long time, or if ever. Let's do one more beat from that album that there isn't a live version of in that show, and it's this one, of course, recorded with one microphone in the foyer of an open mansion. Isn't that a great song? From Jason Rillo's cousin, first time viewing. Wow, thanks, Pete. Thank you, thank you. Fall down the rabbit hole, drink the Kool-Aid, become an addict. Okay, and Steven put the link in there if you all want to submit drumming or music videos. Just make sure it shows the drummer at least. And I feel like playing one more, but... I'm trying to think of, let's see what else is on that same show. If you guys don't mind, and if you guys just want to go, that's fine. But let me just take a look real quick. Looks like something unplugged. Yeah, something did. 1 second. That was the end of Stairway to Heaven. 1 second here. I think I kicked a cord or something. There we go. Okay. Let me see what else is in this show. Oh, I know. We'll do one of my favorites, if you don't mind, for a little. I don't even want to call it an encore, because I think an encore is something people actually wait for or want. But let's do from this show. Come on, where'd the list go? Oh, here we go. Hopefully this version's the same. Why am I doing this when I'm not even sure? Bear with me. I'll check comments one more time before I start to see if this is even a thing. Okay, let's look at the comments one more time. All right, cool, Pete, thanks. Sarah Blakeway says, I've been watching. Wow, for 5 years, it's been really hard with the time zones. I'm also a lifetime member. Awesome, thank you. New newsletter going out, first time in quite a while, actually. Fran Stinsman Jr. says, just stumbled across this. Nice job. You're amusing. Keep it up. Thank you. I don't do anything unless it's fun. So whenever my wife tells me to do something I don't want to do, she says, just make it fun and just do it. There you go. Okay, so we'll do The Song Remains the Same. How's that? I hope it's a lot like in the movie, because I love this song. I'm a little worried about the tempo, because these tempos have been oddly slow on this show, and I don't think it's slowed down. There's no reason to do that with a bootleg. Where's my seat? There we go. Song Remains the Same. Sip of tea. Donate, donate, donate. Please donate. Okay. Love this song. I don't have my glasses on. then it gets mushy. So, hey, I misspoke earlier. Those songs, the first songs from Led Zeppelin IV, were not from this tour. This is the next tour. What was I thinking? This is from The Song Remains the Same tour from the Houses of the Holy album tour. Duh. Anyways, yeah, that's a little muddy, but you get the idea. You get the idea. So there you go. Thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate it very much. Please check out the links in the post. Please. I got to get back to work and then pack. We're leaving in the morning, finally taking a vacation. I'll come around there, turn everything off. Let's do that and turn this off. And I hope you're well. I hope you stay well. And I hope everyone you love is well. And watch what you eat. Get your exercise. And I'll see you when I get back in a couple weeks. We'll be doing this again. And again, I want to thank everybody, seriously, as we wind down the year, it's been a rough couple years, right? I want to thank everybody so much for following what we do on Drum Talk TV. Sign up for the newsletter. A lot of people have been signing up lately, and something new is coming out when I get back. And big announcements. You could be part of our focus group, win stuff. New interviews already being booked. Let's see, should I give one away? Yeah, December 4th. Taylor Moore. Look up Drum Talk TV, Taylor Moore, M-O-O-R-E. This is the young lady whose video went viral the first time we put it up, 4 million views. She's playing Santana. She's playing stand-up percussion, leading the band, and it's amazing. I just got a bunch of new clips from her. So December 4th at noon Pacific, 3 Eastern U.S. times. Watch for those promos. And then we also booked... I don't know if I should say. There's a few others booked and being booked and others selecting dates. So watch for that. And thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye. Thank you. Remember, the link's in the post. Go ahead and